we often need to connect our application with some front-end or third-party services, which usually means writing a lot of code just to expose our data. As with everything in Java, really. But it doesn't have to be that way if you choose the right tools. Today, we'll explore Spring Data REST and compare it with Jmix's Generic REST Add-on to see how each can simplify the development process. We'll use two familiar projects as our starting point, Jmix and Spring Petclinic. I'll leave the links to their repositories in the description below. Imagine you need to expose your entities to third-party services to send such data as pet names from your pet clinic to, for example, a health tracking app for pets. Is that a thing? We can spend a lot of time writing a full REST API for that, or actually use the right tool. First thing first, we'll try to create an API for simple CRUD methods for an existing entity using Spring Data REST. So to work with Spring Data REST, we'll first need to add its dependency. So we already have a repository for our entity. We'll just need to annotate it with a repository REST resource and add a path to this endpoint. Right, I'll call it pet clinic owners. Yeah, and that's it. So with just that, all the CRUD methods have been exposed without any extra code. So when we hit the owners endpoint, as expected, we get a JSON structure listing all the owners in the system. So this is all good, but what if we want to sort them or filter them or get a limited amount of owners? Well, then we will need to extend our repository or write our own methods for each of these filters. So yeah, that would cost us a little bit of boilerplate code still. Now, let's see how Jmix Generic Add-on takes it a step further. It automatically provides filters, pagination, and more advanced queries right out of the box. Let's switch to the Jmix Petclinic project and install the Generic REST Add-on from the marketplace. I've already pre-configured my security settings, so I can just move on to the tests, but you can watch till the end to see how I secured my endpoints or find them in the timecodes below. So let's move on to Postman. Here I'll access the default entity endpoint available from REST entities and the name of your entity. And here we have our pet entries. Okay, so what if we needed to sort our entries or get a limited amount of records? Well, we could simply include these parameters to our get request. So let's say we want to sort our pets by birth date and set our record limit to 2. So as we can see, the results returned the first 2 pets from a sorted list by birthday. So we can also include custom filters using Jmix Search or even JPQL queries. Let's see how to do that. Let's use the search method to find pets whose name contains a particular string. So to access our search endpoint, we'll add search to the pet entity endpoint and include the filter condition to the request's body. So we'll provide the filter criterion in a JSON structure that will contain a set of conditions. We have 3 attributes in the condition: property, which is the attribute name we want to search for, the operator, and the property's value. Right, and there goes our out-of-the-box filter. If we need an advanced query, we can use predefined JPQL queries. For example, we want to search for a pet by its owner's first name. Usually, we would build separate services and controllers for such purposes, but the add-on eliminates most boilerplate using GPQL when all we need is one query. So for that, we will need to define an XML file in the resources folder with the queries that we'll access from our endpoint. We'll first define the query with its unique name, the entity it will fetch, and its fetch plan. Next, we'll write the query itself, so we'll select pets where the owner's first name is equal to the pass parameter. We'll of course include the parameters we want to pass to this query in a separate tag, where we'll define its name and Java type. So here I also have a pre-generated fetch plan. Next, we'll need to add it to our properties file. Finally, we can call the query by its name and include the parameter as a request body if we need a prettier request in a post method. Though we can of course run it as a get request to adhere to a uniform interface. Let's see if it works. Great. These were the main operations we can do with the generic REST add-on. Refer to the documentation for the full list. By default, an initialized Jmix project has a security system in place, so we can't access our entities without authentication. Let's see one way we can secure our entities using bearer tokens. First and foremost, we'll need to install the authentication server add-on. This add-on will issue access tokens to external clients according to the OAuth 2.1 specification. At this point, we'll notice that it has added a set of properties in the properties file to register a client. You can read about each property in Spring Authorization Server documentation. What we're interested in now is the client ID, its secret, and the roles that are accessible to this client. Let's assign it the nurse role. So this role is defined under the security tab, which configures access permissions to its assigned users. Okay, let's test our endpoint. So I will copy the ID beforehand. So in Postman, we'll switch to the authorization tab and choose auth 2.0. Here we chose the client credential as our grant type, and we'll paste the client ID and password in their corresponding fields. And that's basically it. We can get our access token now. Proceed, and we'll use the token it has generated for us. So we can see what's happening in the console, and there we have our token included in the CRUD request. Click on send, and as we can see, everything seems to work just fine. Another way to secure our app is to use OpenID Connect, which we'll cover in another video, so stay tuned. This way, we've seen how to expose our entities with minimum boilerplate code. That's all for today. Consider liking if you find this video useful and subscribe for more content. If you have any questions, ask them in the comments or contact us through social media. Links in the description below. See you in the next video.